Well, good morning, church family. It is Tuesday, April the 28th, and I pray that you are doing well today. I'm praying that God has given you strength today. I'm praying that today you can press forward and do whatever God has laid on your heart to do. Do something today. And my prayer is that today you realize that through His Word, through the Scriptures, God is speaking to us, and there's truth in His Scriptures. And just like kind of a continuation of yesterday's theme, that in Christ there is hope. God is the God of hope, and I want to continue that theme today in our devotion. And it comes out of Matthew chapter 1, verses 18 through 21, and it says this. It says, "This is how the birth of Jesus the Messiah came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they had come together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, 'Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid.'" There's our verse, or little phrase, "Do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." And in this scripture, in this passage, is the verses that I just read. Mary became pregnant by the Holy Spirit, and Joseph, I bet and truly would assume that truly he didn't understand. He didn't understand the situation. He didn't understand what was going on. No matter what Mary was telling him, he didn't understand, and he was going to react in the only way. As a faithful man to the law, he was going to react in the only way that he felt fit to react, and it was kind of probably would have been a disgrace to him, disgrace to Mary at the time in that culture, but he didn't understand, he didn't get it. And then the Bible says that after Joseph had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home to be your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." You see, in the passage, a lot of things were going wrong. The people of God felt... there's people that believe that between the Old and New Testament that God had gone silent and didn't really speak, didn't talk to his children. And the Israelites were, the Jews were struggling to about having a Messiah, having a Savior, someone to come and save them. They didn't understand why he hadn't come or what was going on with that. And then in Joseph's own personal life, a crisis was happening, something that he didn't understand, something that he didn't want to go through. And God spoke to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, do not be afraid." And then he kind of gave the plan of what was going on. And in our lives today, in our situations globally that's going on, in our situations nationally, and then in our own little state and our own little community, we don't understand the situation. And then even in our own little individual lives, the stuff that's going on that we don't understand, I want to tell you that God says, "Do not be afraid, because I am God." And I believe that He speaks hope into Joseph here. And I believe that God can do the same thing for you and for me. Through His Scriptures, I believe God speaks to us. And so today, what I want to tell you is this, is whatever the circumstance that you're going through that you don't understand, because I know there's a lot of circumstances going on that we don't understand, that we question why is this happening? I want to give you hope just to say, Don't be afraid. God is speaking to us through His Word. And He says, don't be afraid. There is hope. There is something that will come out of this. What it is, I don't know. But my prayer is that during this time, through all the hurt, during this time, that you would get into God's Word and let the truth of His Word massage our heart, massage your spirit. And with that, we have hope. And so God speaks into our hope because He is the God of, speaks into our lives because He is the God of hope. And I believe He speaks into our lives through His Word. So my prayer is today that you take some time, you pause, you get into God's Word, begin to read the book of John, the Gospel of John. It's in the New Testament. Seek through John. Seek what Jesus, who Jesus was and what He said and what He did for us. No matter what you're going through, no matter the heartache or pain, or maybe you're just tired of being quarantined, just take time today, pause, and get into His Word. And I promise you, the God of heaven, through the Holy Spirit, will speak to you. Let's pray. Jesus, I want to thank You for this day. God, I give You glory for what You're going to do today. God, I thank You for Your Son Jesus and the grace and mercy that comes through Him. And God, my prayer is that today You shower Your love, Your Holy Spirit. God, You just shower Your grace upon the people that are struggling today, that are hurting today. God, that You would wrap them in Your arms, that You would hold them tightly and know that, and let them know that You have not left them. And God, that You speak through Your Word. And I thank You for speaking through Your Word. God, and I thank You that You are the God of hope. In You there is hope. And I'm praying for all of us today, Lord, that we can have that hope. That we somehow, some way, can sit on the truth of Your Word. And stand on the truth of Your Word. Kneel on the truth of Your Word. Whatever. Just be in the truth of Your Word, God. So that we can make it through this day and this season of our life. God, I love You and I thank You for who You are, in Jesus' name. Amen. Church family, I love you. I miss you. Praying for you today. May you get to have time. Just pause today and get into God's Word. Read the Gospel of John. Listen to the words of Jesus. Get to know Him, the Son of the Almighty King. Who is the Almighty King, the Son of the Almighty God. And I'm praying that today you will find hope, even if it's just a glimmer, that you will find peace and that you will find rest in Him. Get into the truth of God's Word, stand on it, and remember, in Christ Jesus, there's always hope. God bless and have a great day.